Hi, I'm Rukmini, and this is part two of a three-part series on resilience in the context of COVID-19. This video is produced in partnership with the Help Library as a part of our efforts to put out tools that may be of help to you in these challenging times. Now, if you have not viewed the first part of the series, on what resilience is, I strongly recommend that you do catch up on that video when you can to better understand the concept of resilience. Having said that, I hope that this video independently also helps you reflect on your own sense of resilience and on how you can develop it going forward. So what you see here on the screen right now is a model of resilience, a way of looking at it, a way of working with the idea of resilience such that it leads to holistic well-being. It integrates various aspects of our life, behavior, and choices that together contribute to our sense of well-being. You'll notice that there are six factors, each equally critical, that have an impact on our wellness. And of these six, one is a matter of physical health, and all the others are related to mental, emotional, and spiritual health. So we'll start with vision. Now you might wonder why vision is relevant here. Going back to the way we defined resilience in the first video of the series, we know that it's all about bouncing back. It's about trusting that life is cyclical. And therefore, regardless of our current position in the cycle, it's important to develop well-being in a manner that we nurture our vision for the future and stay true to it. One of the many ways in which that can be done is to have clarity of goals, goals related to self, to your community, to the planet, and to focus on what you can do to contribute in each of these spaces. Next comes composure. This is about objectively assessing how are you managing your emotions during this phase in life. Is there a need to exercise more emotional intelligence? For you to have a clear picture on this, by all means introspect, but also do proactively seek feedback from others to get a neutral perspective. The third piece is reasoning. This is about your ability to logically and rationally respond to the situation without giving in to fear or panic. It's about finding ways to repurpose your internal and external resources in creative ways. It's also about tapping into your ability to adapt to change, not by tolerating change, but by knowing that life is cyclical and therefore change, even if it seems extreme, is natural. The fourth factor that lends itself to well-being is tenacity. This is about bouncing back. It's about being committed to life and to flourishing in whatever form is appropriate in the given moment. Tenacity is how bamboo trees survive high velocity of winds, where other trees may get uprooted in the process because they resist. The bamboo instead bends without breaking. The fifth factor is collaboration. Reach out for support when you need to. And of course, be available to others when they reach out, whenever you reasonably can be available. This is about building social support systems actively all along, not just in times of crisis. Do you actively nurture relationships that you care about regularly in your life? And finally, there is the aspect of health. How's your physical health? Do you have enough movement, nutrition, and sleep that ensures that you're reasonably fit most of the time in life? So here's what I'm going to leave you with. I invite you to take a moment, perhaps pause the video where this framework is still visible on the screen, and rate yourself on each of these six areas, perhaps on a scale of 10. If you would like a deeper reflection, rate yourself on each of the elements listed below these six areas. Such a self-assessment could help you understand what specific areas you need to work on to enhance your resilience. And if the rating is low in any of these areas, remember that resilience is about trusting that it can be changed. All you need is some mindful effort. In the last part of the series of talks, I will share with you how you can work on a balancing act that will enable you to uphold resilience not only in a crisis, but to make it a regular practice of your life. Until then, take care.